بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا حسنا وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله يرفع بهذا الكتاب أقواما ويضع به آخرين أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام Honorable علماء الكرام Respected brothers Young friends, mothers and sisters listening at home. Today is the first of Rajab. The commencement of Rajab has started, which is a honorable month in the calendar of Islam. Rajab is a month which brings for the Ummah, for the Muslims, a signal, a month that brings an alert to the Muslims that you are only 2 months away from Ramadan now. And it is about time that we start to prepare for the blessed month of Ramadan. Upon the advent of the month of Rajab, it is narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to recite the dua, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. That, O Allah, grant us barakah. Grant us blessings in this month of Rajab and Sha'ban and make us reach the month of Ramadan. Meaning that this blessed month is coming, the month of Ramadan. Let not happen that we die before this month now that we have started Rajab. Now that we have started Rajab, if death is muqaddar for us, then let it happen after the month of Ramadan. So we can reap and we can gain the benefits of this beloved month of Ramadan. Hence, my brothers, it is very important that we also embrace the month of Ramadan, the month of Rajab, the month of Sha'ban, just the way Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to embrace it. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the role model. He is the being that every Muslim should endeavor, every Muslim should have the zeal to follow and have the zeal to follow in his footsteps. It is narrated regarding other pious predecessors that not just Rajab, but in fact 6 months before Ramadan would start, they would start to make the dua that, Ya Allah, grant us the ability to reach Ramadan. And once Ramadan would pass, for another 5 months they would make dua that, Ya Allah, accept our deeds of Ramadan. So my brothers, today amongst us, we will see some people. There will be some people that were amongst us last year in Ramadan, but sadly they are not with us this year. And maybe there are some people amongst us today that might be in this Ramadan, but after the next Ramadan, after this Ramadan, they might not be with us. So it is a duty of every mu'min, every Muslim, that he prepares accordingly for the month of Ramadan. And it is very important that, just like other occasions in our life, whether it's going for Hajj, whether it's a wedding, whether it's somebody going abroad, we do not make preparations the day before. Preparations start well in advance. If it's a wedding, maybe 6-7 months before preparations are being made. We are mentally being prepared, physically we are being prepared. In the same way, it is very important that before Ramadan starts, we mentally prepare ourselves. We physically prepare ourselves, and spiritually we prepare ourselves as well. And one of the things that we have to do is that we need to start increasing our ibadah. And this is the most important part. Because Ramadan comes, it is not that we start to prepare for Ramadan, the first of Ramadan. In fact, we need to start to gather the strength. We need to get the stamina so that we can follow up till Ramadan and increase in Ramadan. Because if a person starts to prepare the good deeds on the first of Ramadan, before he gets into the routine, before he can gather some strength, it will be too late and it will be the last few days of Ramadan. Hence why Rasulullah ﷺ would make dua, Allahum barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban, that Ya Allah give us barakat so we can stand up and we can start to prepare well before Ramadan, 2 months, 60 days in advance. And how should we prepare? It is very important that we make a timetable. We understand what we are going to do and how we are going to do it gradually, so that as soon as Ramadan enters, we are ready. Just like nowadays people go to a gym, not that people should go to a gym, just an example that it is understandable, that you cannot start lifting weights up straight away. You cannot start picking 50 kg up in one day. It's gradual. You start with 5, you carry on for 5 for a week, you go on to 10, from 10, 2 weeks later, you go on to 15. In the same way, my brothers, because throughout the year we have disconnected ourselves, or we have little connection with the Quran and ibadats, with namaz, with jamaat, it's not going to happen overnight. Hence, it is very important that we start prior, and this is why this dua has been made. So how should we start? We should fix a time that now Ramadan is coming, I need to start, I need to be serious, and we need to make a timetable that I am only reciting a quarter a day, I'm going to start with a quarter, or I'm reciting nothing, I'm going to start with one ruku. And slowly, slowly, every week, monitor ourselves that first of Rajab, today the 7th of Rajab, how much have I increased? Am I on one ruku? Have I gone down? Have I prayed a few days? Have I missed a few days? Monitor ourselves. Monitoring is very important. And after the 7th of Rajab, fix 3 rukus. If you're on a quarter, fix half. If you're reciting half, fix 3 quarters. And gradually we need to increase ourselves in tilawat. And then we will see that when the month of Ramadan comes, we will be ready and fit. The stamina will be there. The zeal will be there. The eagerness will be there to carry on, and we will start Ramadan with 3 paras already on. And you can increase on the 10th of Ramadan to 5 paras, 5 juz daily, from 5 to 10 paras, to 10, and so on until the end of Ramadan. We will see that inshallah this Ramadan we have increased in ibadah. The likes of Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi is mentioned that in Ramadan he used to recite 41 Quran khatams, one in Taraweeh, one daily walking, wherever he was doing, whatever tasks he was doing, he would recite Quran daily, and daily he would do one khatam. So if it's a 30 day Ramadan, 30 khatams throughout the day, then one for Taraweeh, and in the night in Tahajjud he used to recite 10 juz daily. So every 3 nights he would do a khatam, 30 nights there would be 10 khatams, 41 khatams throughout the year, throughout the month of Ramadan. Imam Shafi rahmatullah alayhi, he used to do approximately 60 khatams. But my brothers, this is because the Quran was their shagaf. The Quran was their daily routine. And how did they come to this routine? By effort, by desire, by working hard. And for, same with us, we need, if once a person puts his effort, inshallah he will get the love, he will get the zeal, and daily he will increase. As Sheikh Zakir rahmatullah alayhi's father, as the Mullah Yahya rahmatullah alayhi, he used to recite one khatam daily, and the people are amongst him, they used to see, and they used to realize and experience that as soon as iftar time would come close by, Hazrat would be walking near the dastakhan, and he would be reciting the last few surahs of the Quran. He would be reciting Alam Tara, Li'ilafi Quraysh, Ara'ita, and so forth till he would do the khatam. So my brothers, the first thing we need to do to prepare ourselves for Ramadan is that we start to recite the Quran. If you have not recited throughout the year, then this is something that we have disconnected ourselves. And the Quran is such a kitab. Allah Rasulullah says, "Inna Allah yarfa'u bihadha al-kitabi aqwam." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates people through this kitab. Once as Umar radiallahu anhu was in Asfan, out of Makkah Mukarramah. And in Makkah Mukarramah, he had his governor, Nafi ibn Harith al-Khuzai. He was the governor of Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu in Makkah Mukarramah. And once in Asfan, Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu saw his governor. And he asked him, "What are you doing in Asfan? You meant to be in Makkah Mukarramah. What are you doing? Who have you left behind in Makkah Mukarramah as your deputy? Because you are the governor." So he said, "I have left Ibn Abza." So Umar radiallahu anhu did not know who Ibn Abza was. So he said, "Who's Ibn Abza? You've left a governor in Makkah Mukarramah, and you've left Ibn Abza that we don't even know who he is." He said, "Ibn Abza is my freed slave." "Freed slave? And you've made him a governor upon so many luminaries are in Makkah Mukarramah?" He said, "Huwa qari'un li kitabillah wa 'alimun bil fara'id." He was a slave yesterday, but through knowledge, he's a reciter of the Quran and he knows a lot of ahkam. Upon this, Hazrat Umar radiallahu anhu told Ibn Nafi that I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that Inna Allah yarfau bihadha al-kitab aqwama, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will elevate some people through his kitab. And this is the example. When a person connects himself to a Quran, he will see that he will get honor, he will get izzah, people will start to love him. Inna alladhina amanu salihati sayaj'alu lahumu rahman wudda. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put love for him in people's heart. People will incline towards him. And this will be the barakah of the Quran, my brothers. Once Hazrat Shaykhul Hind rahmatullah Ali was put in jail. He was captured in Makkah Mukarramah and he was put in jail. He is a teacher of the likes of Shaykhul Islam Hazrat Hussein Madri rahmatullah Ali, the likes of Hazrat Shafi'i Tahawi rahmatullah Ali. Whilst he was in jail, he stayed in Malta jail for many years. When he came out, all these big luminaries came to see him. And he sat there silently. And then he said, whilst I was in jail, I pondered, I thought, and I think very hard that what is the reason that the Muslims are going down? Why are the Muslims losing? He said, I came to two reasons. I came to a conclusion that Muslims are degrading for two reasons. Number one, they have disconnected themselves with the Quran. They have disconnected themselves with the Quran. And number two, they have got disunity amongst themselves. That's why, my brothers, this is the second part, that whoever leaves the Quran, Rasulullah says that Inna Allah yarfa wa yada'u bil akharin, and whoever leaves the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause them to go down. So my brothers, we need to start reciting the Quran. Secondly, we need to start increasing our time in the masjid. At the moment, if you see, it's mere time. We're giving minimum time to a masjid. It's maybe for a salah, sunnat, nawafil, and we're out. We can spend half an hour, we can spend one hour outside in the shurak area, in the atrium. But to sit in a masjid is very difficult for us. Why? Because our nafs, our internal desires, does not want to sit here. So what do we need to do? Rajab started straight away. After every farz salah, stop it 5 minutes. I'm going to sit in a masjid for 5 minutes. Get the tasbih. Get the Quran Sharif. Read Surah Mulk after Isha. Read Surah Waqi after Isha. After Fajr, sit for 5 minutes. Sit in Ta'lim. Read Surah Yasin Sharif. And like this, slowly. So 15th of Rajab starts, we increase the 5 minutes to 10 minutes. The 10 minutes to 20 minutes. A time will come that in Ramadan we will stick to masjid. Our hearts will be in the masjid. Our hearts will be yearning, longing to go to a masjid. But it starts from now. Whatever we do now, we will see the fruits in Ramadan. Thirdly, what do we need to do? We need to start talking about Ramadan. We need to start embracing Ramadan. We need to talk about it. The people that know about the fazail of Ramadan, they explain to people that do not know the fazail. After namaz, we have the ta'lim of fazail of Ramadan. We need to start listening. What does this do? This will cause a zeal in our heart. We'll be ready. We'll be geared up for Ramadan. We will go in. We will go in like a mountain. And we will work. That's why the Mu'ashafi Tanu Rahmatullah Ali says in one of his Malfuzat, that those deeds, those good acts that are carried out in Ramadan, inshallah, you will see the effects of it throughout the 11 months. Whatever acts you do in Ramadan, if a person becomes frequent with tahajjud in Ramadan, inshallah, outside Ramadan will become easy for him. If a person becomes frequent with awabin in Ramadan, it will become easy for him outside Ramadan. If a person becomes frequent with tilawat of the Quran in Ramadan, for the rest of the 11 months, it will become easy for him. So we need to create this zeal from now. And how do we do it? By sitting in ta'lim, by listening to the fazail of Ramadan. It will cause this inner desire, a longing that when will Ramadan come. And this was the Sahaba and Rasulullah, they had a longing. For us sometimes, it's not a longing, it's opposite. We take Ramadan as a burden. Na'udhu billah, may Allah save us, al-hafidh wal-aman. That we think, oh, Ramadan's coming. We've got to fast long hours. Oh, 20 hours, 20 rakats tarawih is coming. We won't be able to watch movies. We won't be able to watch films. We have to pack the games away. No, my brothers, we have to embrace Ramadan. Ramadan is filled with virtue. Ramadan is filled with blessings. So many benefits. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is descending His special rahmat upon the ummah. So my brothers, we need to go into Ramadan with this mindset, with this spiritual and this mental mindset, that I am going for Ramadan not as a burden. It's going to be a means of Allah's forgiveness. Allah's forgiveness descends upon the people like rain, buckets of rain. So my brothers, this is the third point. The fourth point, we need to stay away from layani. We need to stay away from futile talks. We need to stay away from futile acts. Social media, we need to start cutting down now. If you are spending 2 hours on WhatsApp, if you are spending 2 hours on Facebook, cut it down now. Rajab starts, we need to cut it down to 1 hour 45 minutes. If you can't do it altogether is absolutely perfect. If you can't do it, start with it slowly. If you're playing games, my youngsters today nowadays, there's a craze about games, and there's people playing till 5 o'clock in the morning. Youngsters waking up at 2 o'clock just to play a game. My young friends, we are wasting time. This time is life. This time is what we're going to be asked upon on the day of Qiyamah. So we need to stop packing these things away. First of Rajab, if you are engrossing games in WhatsApp, in Facebook, in futile talks, in talking and sitting with friends after Isha, we start cutting down. We need to fix a time that, no, I'm not going to spend my 2 hours talking and walking and joking with my friends. I'm going to cut it to 1.5 hours, and the half an hour I'm going to spend in good time. I'm going to start reading kitabs. I'm going to start praying tasbih. I'm going to give family time. I'm going to give my children time. I'm going to give my children a good tarbiyah. And slowly, slowly, 15th of Rajab comes, cut it down to 1 hour. When Shaban starts, the first of Shaban, cut it down even more. And before Ramadan comes, all finished. Before Ramadan, just like a person going on a trip, going abroad, before he goes abroad, he tries to tie all the he ties not everything up. He tries to clear everything out. He tries to get everything out of the way. Similarly, my brothers, Ramadan is coming. Let's get everything that is not needed. Let's get everything which is useless. Let's get everything that wastes our time out of the way. Get it clear and dust it away. So that in Ramadan, we are not getting diverted. In Ramadan, we are not getting derailed. So my brothers, there are a few things. And most importantly, before Ramadan comes, we need to start looking upon ourselves. We need to start to take calculations. We need to take stock of ourselves. Am I doing sins? Am I in a gunai kabira? Am I doing something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes? Because if a person goes in Ramadan with this same sin, then just like doing good deeds in Ramadan has an effect in the rest of the 11 months, similarly doing a guna in Ramadan will have an effect in the next 11 months. My brothers, from now we need to start looking upon ourselves. That what have I got inside me? Am I doing ghibah? Am I looking at wrong things? Am I in a relationship with the wrong person? Am I eating wrong things? Am I smoking wrong things? Am I drinking wrong things? And we need to start looking upon ourselves. We need to cut down. We need to, guna totally gone. We have to stop altogether. And we have to make a firm intention that inshallah, I'm going to enter Ramadan with a clean sheet. I'm going to enter Ramadan in the best possible manner. And inshallah, we will see that this Ramadan could be the Ramadan that changes our life. Because just like a person takes up a course in college, university, after 4 years the course, the person becomes a doctor. He's a doctor for the rest of his life. In the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that he is ordained Ramadan, la'allakum tattaqoon. So that you become muttaqi. And a person that becomes muttaqi, he does not become muttaqi just for Ramadan. If he spends Ramadan the way he should spend, if he does the correct deeds, if he stays away from sin, he will become muttaqi in Ramadan and he will become muttaqi for the rest of his life. It's a course. Just like a course, a person becomes a qualified doctor after 4 years. This is a 30-day course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained. If a person does what has been prescribed upon him for 30 days, inshallah, after 30 days, he will become a complete muttaqi. And he will not become muttaqi for 1 day or 2 days. He will become muttaqi for the rest of life. Now, the only way that we can get this taqwa out of him, if he does something really wrong, if he does something totally against, it's like a doctor. Once he becomes a doctor, he's a doctor for the rest of his life. Only if he goes totally, if he does something which is totally wrong, then the authority will come and strike him off. They'll take his certificate of him. In the same way, if a person does something major, then his taqwa will go. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has left a room. He's left a door, tawbah. As soon as a person does tawbah, inshallah, he will come back onto on the track of taqwa, and inshallah, he will be back as a muttaqi. So my respected brothers, youngsters, ulama kiram, very important, we start preparing from now. First of Rajab,
Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة لا
Just one quick announcement. Out of the many qualities of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially in Ramadan, one quality that would stand out, which was outstanding, was his generosity. And it is mentioned, وَكَانَ أَجْوَرُ مَا يَكُونُ فِي رَمَضَانِ. He was very generous in the month of Ramadan. His giving was immense. And like I said, this today's topic was about preparing for Ramadan. So a stepping stone for us is that we start being generous from now. One local project which has been announced already for the previous 2 weeks is a project of our kitchen. Brothers are requested, please donate generously towards this project. It's our own local project. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all your giving. Jazakallah.
Hayya 'alas salah. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولًا سديدًا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزًا عظيمًا ألا وإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد فيا أيها المؤمنون اتقوا الله تعالى حق التقوى أيها الإخوة قد أظلكم شهر رمضان الكريم حيث فيه مغفرة الذنوب وتكفير السيئات ومضاعفة الحسنات أيها الإخوة ولو نذرنا حولنا لوجدنا أن بعضا ممن أدرك رمضان الماضي أصبح من أهل القبور وربما البعض منا في هذا العام ممن يقدر الله له أن يصوم رمضان كاملا فيقدر الله ألا يكون من أهل الدنيا بعده فيكون آخر رمضان يصومه ويقومه ولو استشعر كل منا هذا الأمر واستعد للموت بعد رمضان أو في أثنائه وصام رمضان إيماناً واحتساباً وقامه أيضاً إيماناً واحتساباً لنال السعادة والفوز بالجنة فرغم أنف ثم رغم أنف من أدرك رمضان ولم يغفر له أيها الإخوة إن الاستعداد في رمضان يكون بمحاسبة النفس على تقصيرها سواء بالتقصير في تحقيق الشهادتين أو التقصير في الواجبات أو التقصير في عدم ترك ما نقع فيه من الشهوات أو الشبهات فيقوم العبد سلوكه ليكون في رمضان على درجة عالية من الإيمان فالإيمان يزيد وينقص يزيد بالطاعة وينقص بالمعصية أيها الإخوة علينا أن نحاسب أنفسنا على تقصير في الفعل الطاعات كالتقصير في أداء صلوات جماعة وذكر الله عز وجل وأداء حقوق للجار وللأرحام وللمسلمين وإفشاء السلام والأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر والتواصي بالحق والصبر على ذلك وبالصبر عن الفعل المنكرات أو بالصبر على فعل الطاعات أو بالصبر على أقدار الله عز وجل ثم تكون محاسبة على فعل المعاصي واتباع الشهوات بمنع أنفسنا من الاستمرار عليها أي معصية كانت صغيرة أو كبيرة سواء كانت معصية بالعين بالنظر إلى ما حرم الله أو بالسماع للمعازف أو بالمشي فيما لا يرضي الله عز وجل أو بالبطش باليدين فيما لا يرضي الله أو بالأكل ما حرم الله من الربا والرشوة أو غير ذلك مما يدخل في أكل الأموال الناس بالباطل ويكون نصب أعيننا أيها الإخوة أن الله رحيم ودود غفور رحيم يبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل ويبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار وقد قال سبحانه وتعالى وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين بهذه المحاسبة وبالتوبة والاستغفار يجب علينا أن نستقبل رمضان فالكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت والآجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله الأماني اللهم كما بلغتنا رجب فبلغنا شعبان ورمضان ونسألك اللهم أن تعيننا على الصيام والقيام وفعل الطاعات وترك المنكرات إنك ولي ذلك والقادر عليه واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله والداعي إلى رضوانه صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحابته وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله تعالى ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا واذكروا نعمة الله عليكم وتمسكوا بكتاب ربكم فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم واحذروا البدع والمحدثات فإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وكل بدعة ضلالة ألزموا الجماعة المسلمين فإن يد الله مع الجماعة المسلمين ثم اعلموا أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ في نفسه فقال جل جلاله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك ورسولك محمد البشير النذير والسراج المنير ورضى اللهم عن أربعة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن بقية الصحابة وعن التابعين وتابعي التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم بعفوك وكرمك وإحسانك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين وانصر عبادك الموحدين اللهم ادفع عنا الغلا والرياء والربا والزنا والزلازل والمحن وسوء الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن عن بلدنا وعن سائر بلاد المسلمين عامة يا رب العالمين اللهم جلنا هداة مهتدين صالحين مصلحين اللهم ثبتنا للقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأوفوا بعهد الله إذا عاهدتم ولا تنقضوا الأيمان بعد توكيدها وقد جعلتم الله عليكم كفيلا إن الله يعلم ما تفعلون واذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا وأنتم تعلمون وإن كنتم في ريب مما نزلنا على عبدنا فأتوا بسورة من مثله وادعوا شهداءكم من دون الله إن كنتم صادقين فإن لم تفعلوا ولن تفعلوا فاتقوا النار التي وقودها الناس والحجارة أعدت للكافرين وبشر الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها كلما رزقوا منها من ثمرة رزقا قالوا هذا الذي رزقنا من قبل وأتوا به متشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة وهم فيها خالدون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك اللهم اجعلنا هداة مهتدين غير ضالين ولا مضلين اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان ربي ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين